Not everyone gets a bird's eye view of the Catawba Sustainability Center, but for Virginia Tech researchers, drones are coming in handy on the 377-acre property. Wetlands restoration is in the works, and agroforestry projects abound. Agroforestry involves the integration of trees into agriculture, trees that not only produce food such as fruits and nuts, but also protect the land and promote water quality in how they are cultivated. The drone lands with its millions of laser points ready to translate into information that computer visualization experts can analyze. Data can show the steepness of a riverbank or help decide what to plant where or even find weeds, which could then later be zapped with a different drone. One great thing about the topographical maps being produced is that anyone working with a center on geospatial applications or other projects will have access to them. Not everything at Catawba is high-tech, but it's all vital to furthering knowledge to make for a healthier planet.
We have numerous projects happening here on the farm where we work with faculty members from Virginia Tech and draw off their expertise to implement these projects right here on the ground. One project in particular that we're working on is from a grant from the National Fish and Wildlife Service that was awarded to the College of Natural Resources and Environment, where we are planting a riparian buffer zone with a mix of fruit and nut trees that can also be harvested and used as production for farmers wanting to implement a similar practice on their land.
Students are involved. Some are volunteers. Others have been working alongside Professor John Munsell for the past 7 years on agroforestry projects. They've helped plant more than 1,000 trees on the property this year. Also, in an orchard elsewhere on the property, the center is participating in a nationwide volunteer effort to bring the American chestnut tree back from extinction. Munsell says that Virginia Tech, working with a community as well as state and federal agencies, has transformed the landscape. A mostly barren and largely abandoned former dairy farm is now alive with food and fiber production, nudging the landscape back toward biodiversity. Where will it all lead? To a demonstration, researchers hope, of how farmscapes don't necessarily have to pollute and denude the land. They can also protect and nurture it. For Outreach and International Affairs, this is Andrea Brunet reporting.